Okay, I'm gonna awkwardly smile the whole time.
Oh, that's totally fine. I'd rather have you smile than give me like dagger eyes or something.
Okay. My name is Kolbie Chen, and I've worked here for about 6 months, and I am in reception and greeter and sometimes pharmacy now. Usually I open up the building, so I'm always here first, and so I open up in greeting most of the time, and then I work in phones in the afternoon. So you greet all the customers when they come in. You gotta stay upbeat and positive and make them feel at home and love on their animals when they come in. They love that. But we weigh the animals when they come in, and then you seat them, ask them if they need a water or anything to drink, and get them ready for their visit. And in phones, we schedule all the appointments, any scheduling really that needs done, answer all the emails, all the phone calls, calm patients if they call us in a panic. Anything like that. I came in for an appointment. I was switching vets, trying to find a new one, and Gus had an ear infection. And so I came in and was just in there, and I had just switched jobs. And well, I was a nanny for 7 years and I was looking for a new position. And I was talking to Dr. Lehman at the time and was telling her, everybody was so nice when I came in. And I was like, hey, if you ever need anybody, by the way, you can call Gus's mom. And she was like, are you serious about that? And I was like, yeah. She was like, let me get Dr. King really quick and see if she can talk to you. And I was like, okay. And she came in and talked to me. And I was like, well, awesome. And she was like, yeah, well, I'm gonna get you with Kayla Biddles and talk to her a little bit, who was the manager at the time. And yeah, I chatted with her and I came in like that week and did all my interviews really fast. So, yeah, it was pretty cool. Everybody was just so nice, and all female, you know, everybody, it just, I don't know, everybody was just awesome here, and it was such a positive environment. I just loved it. And I hadn't worked with coworkers in so long, and it was so nice to have that back. So, yeah, because it was so long without anybody. And I was like, gosh, it's so nice to have other women to work with. Gus is awesome, but he was my sister's dog. So he's a Frenchie, and he, my sister got him as a puppy. So he was always in our family, but she was pregnant with twins. And right before they were born, he got a slip disc, I think it was. And you know, they weren't sure how it happened, but he just quit walking using his back legs one day. And so she took him in to get a surgery done, and they told us it was like 50-50 chance if it worked, if he'd walk again. And the surgery ended up not working, but took away the pain. So he's able to live happy with it. So she tried that for a little bit. The twins were born and just couldn't handle, you know, it was a lot for her. So I told my husband that we were finding a home for him and brought him home, and then he ended up just staying with us forever. First, I had two dogs at the time, and they were big dogs, and they took to him right away. They like loved him, and he used his wheelchair a lot at first, but in our house he really doesn't use it at all. He doesn't like it, and really, so unless we're out somewhere, he doesn't use it. And he's fast. He gets around just fine. He can jump on things. He's totally good without those back legs, so.
You know, for me, it's like almost a second home now, you know, and I feel like it's just becoming more and more that, you know, you wanna like where you work, because you're there almost more than you are at home sometimes. And so being able to have that environment and other women to become friends with and stuff like that, so nice to have.